Agriculture is mainly the backbone of many, many African countries. And over the years, population growth has also added a bit of pressure onto the agricultural production systems. And recently, if you look at the SDGs, particularly SDG 2, SDG 10 and SDG 15 that are aimed at eliminating hunger, sustaining biodiversity, reducing inequality, you realize that these are also interconnected with agriculture. And so once every nation or most of the nations in Africa are pushing to achieve these goals, there are also implications for agricultural expansion or increased crop production or increased yields, you know, and these really have a great impact on biodiversity, because we all know, for instance, if you take farming or crop production, with increased population growth, we need more food, we have more mouths to feed, so more food. And previous analysis or previous studies have shown that most of this increase in food production is done through expansion of land. You know, so increase in land size, but not increase in input. And so if you are increasing land size, then you end up creating a reduction in biodiversity to some extent. The other aspect is that you want to increase food production, you may have to introduce input, for instance, pesticides. And pesticides, we all know they have great impacts on the environment. They affect life in the soil, they affect lives on the surface of the soil that is above ground, biodiversity. They affect aquatic life, and possibly there's also reducing the quality of air that also affects us human beings. So these are the challenges. So the project Sentinel is aimed at analyzing, identifying the impacts, the risk, and the trade-offs that are associated with agricultural pathways in African agriculture. And the focus is on Ethiopia, Ghana, and Zambia. And I am particularly from Ghana. Its aim or its goal is to include policymakers. You know, over the years, researchers conduct research and the output is just published and then kept somewhere. Nobody knows about it or nobody really cares. But here the project aims at starting by engaging with stakeholders. So from the government side, from the public and the private sector, we want to engage them, create awareness that there are impacts, there are trade-offs, there are risks in agriculture pathways in each of these three focus countries. And at the end of the day, our goal is to be able to create informed decisions about all of these effects, impacts, risk, trade-offs related to agricultural pathways, so that whenever they are formulating policies, they have in mind that whatever program, whatever project we want to implement to improve food production, to enhance or increase food security, we have these implications connected. Okay, so that policies are planned in such a way that they are aimed at reducing such impacts, such risk, and such trade-offs, so that we'll be able to really achieve SDG 2, SDG 10, and SDG 15. And the other interesting aspect of it is the use of scenario development. It's one thing I'm not really familiar with, and it's very important for me to be able to know how to use scenario development, you know, to analyze life issues. One aspect was to enhance relationships between African and UK partners, I mean researchers and also the research organizations. And so personally, I really look forward to more stronger relationships, not only for this project, but future projects. That is for me. And then for my organization, I think basically the same issue applies, because once I am there, I am, as I'm seated here, you see University of Ghana. So it is not just about me, it's also about the entire institution. So even if I leave the institution today and then there is a need for kind of collaboration in the future, they will look for University of Ghana and probably my department or maybe a related department. So it's a kind of benefit that I really appreciate much, that, you know, relation, that establishment of a strong partnership, so that we'll be able to sustain research collaboration. Then also for Ghana, my expectation is linked to the goal of the project, Sentinel. I expect that at the end of the project, that is at the end of the 4-year period, our stakeholders, everyone in the country, not only those in government, actively in government, but even the citizens, will be able to realize that no, these things we are doing, our way of producing food, the agricultural pathway, currently I call it business as usual. So at the end of the project, everybody should begin to realize that business as usual is not going to help us. And so whatever policies we formulate to increase food production or even to contribute to economic development of the country, we should bear in mind that we have effects on other sectors of our environment. Okay, so that when we are taking decisions, they should be responsible decisions.